And it's live streaming time. I know I said something about maybe coloring Kirby Rose Sands World Within Worlds last Sunday, but because of the way my mood has been going and the fact that I kind of have had the color palette for this picture probably for over a year, kind of in my mind, I decided that this picture from Mythographic Animals by Joseph Katzenbaum would be perfect, especially for this time of year. And as I got my blotter sheet out, I had a little bit of a giggle because obviously these are colors that I have used before in the past. But there's something about using the pinks, violets, greeny blues with some of the yellow, orangey colors. It's kind of like the RGB, cyan, magenta, and yellow kind of color tones. So I know it's something that I do quite frequently, but guess what? I'm gonna do it anyways because that's what I'm feeling at the moment. Okay, so now that we've got that shared out, now the idea here is, hi Lisa, is to, for the hummingbird, I want to give it a pink belly, and then the hummingbird itself is going to be more of the green. It's going to be more on the green of the blue-green scale. And then I want to do these flowers pink. And then the petal or the I can't think of the word leaf. I'm gonna do the leaves more of like the bluey tones of the blue green so that it starts feeling a little bit more like a background than it does leaves because of just how, hi Kathy, just how this picture is always set up. There's always so much going on. I want to kind of simplify it. And then that just leaves these like odd random objects that are always scattered throughout these pages. I'm gonna do more in these orangey, yellowy, goldy colors. That's tentatively what I have in mind. So I'm going to start, as always, with my pinks because I just like my pinks. So I have R81, which is the rose pink for my lightest color. I have RV55, which is the hollyhock for my middle tone, and then VO5 Azulia, I can never say that one, for my dark color. So technically, I have a pink, I have a red, and I have a violet that I'm gonna kind of mix together. But I'm going to tentatively open these up. So I have these already. So his, it kind of goes around here. And then we'll probably get some in here. So I'm just gonna lay the light down everywhere. Real quick. Just so I can the full idea of where all these are gonna hit. And then I'll come back with the darker pink tones. Because, as per usual, I'm kind of making it up. I don't know. There's something about these pages, though. That I really like doing. I think the next picture after this will definitely be that page in Worlds Within Worlds that I was talking about. But part of me is like, I've had the color scheme. I need to sit down and actually color it. Okay. So I'm gonna take, I think this, violet. And I'm gonna get it kind of in the belly region. And come back with a hollyhock. The interesting part, of course, is always trying to color around these little tiny little petals without accidentally coloring them. So something kind of like that. I think I'll just kind of wrap that around the belly. So it's not necessarily the bright fuchsia pink that I have a tendency to gravitate towards. It's more of that purpley, magenta-y pink. I also just wanted to use Copics again. And you can't really use Copics within World Within Worlds because of the double-sided nature of it. Might pull a little bit the hollyhock into some areas. So we can deepen up the tones a little bit. That'll kind of be his belly. I just want to do one flower just so I can sort of get a feel for how I want to do the flowers. Because I don't necessarily want the flowers to bleed into the hummingbird. Maybe I won't put any, or if I do, it might just be a tiny touch of the violet, but not a lot. Welcome. So that they're kind of in the same tone, but you get more of the purple, the violet within the hummingbird. I think that's where I want to sit with that. But before I get too far with flowers, I think I actually want to finish the hummingbird first. So for the hummingbird, I'm going to have the BG11, which is the moon white. I'm going to have BG01, which is the aqua blue, and then the BG15, which is aqua. BG11 is going to be more of my base color for this guy. And then my darkest is going to be the BG15, which I kind of and then I'll come back with the BG01, which will add a little bit of that blue in there. Just to add different kind of depth to it. Oh, yay! I'm glad you could come and join me. I love when people just sit down and color with me. Just kind of background noise. I'm trying to kind of make this line not so harsh between the two. But yeah, that's kind of how I want to do the hummingbird. I like that. Okay, so then we have it just says wings. We've got little pieces within these leaves. Like I said, sometimes it's a struggle to decide what is hummingbird and what is not. A little bit of blue tone to those. Hi, Candy. Happy Sunday. I'm just kind of enjoying this quiet weekend. Things have been just a touch crazy around here. Around all these little tiny pieces. Mostly because we've still got construction going on in the basement. So during the week, it gets a little crowded and hectic around here. But the end is in sight. And I'm very thankful for that. I think we have some wing here. Kind of giving it a, or going for a painterly like quality, at least that's what I'm aiming for in my brain. So the lines aren't perfect, but gives it a sense of motion. But the good thing about Copics is, but if it doesn't quite look right, you can, of course, keep adding layers until you have the look you're going for. And it's nice to be able to color an area pretty quickly. Because that's one thing about coloring that Disney page that took forever with the Holbeins. I mean, I love the way that turned out. But holy cow. Layering those colored pencils and trying to get the tone that I wanted. I always come back to the Copic for that very reason. Excuse me, random turnip. But how is everybody else's weekend going? Is everybody coping with everything? I'm glad to see all of you guys on the live stream. I actually went out into the world for a little bit for the first time in several weeks. Which, you know, when you're in the house for that long and seeing the same set of people, it's kind of interesting to remember that, hey, other people do exist. still surprises me. How many cars you end up seeing on the road? Though I suppose it was a Saturday. And everybody else is feeling a little bit stir crazy. Around that butterfly. It's just something about that brush tip and that sound. That squeaky little marker sound. I contemplated whether or not if I wanted to do this page all in Copic or if I wanted to do a layer of colored pencil at the very end, but I think I might just leave it Copic because it's been a while since I've done just a Copic page. There's something very therapeutic about it. I'm loving how this hummingbird is looking right now. These I think I need. Blending out just a touch more. You can kind of still see the marker strokes. They don't really want that. Probably just a touch of green along these pink edges. Starting to look like it's alive. Like it. Whoop! Almost threw the marker. That would have been disastrous. Just wanna deepen up some of these areas a little bit more. Okay. Yeah, something kind of like that. Okay, so I'm gonna go back through and start doing a little bit more of the flowers. Or do I want to kind of see how some of the leaves look and the random objects? Maybe. Okay, we'll play with the yellow, oranges, reds real quick, just so I can kind of see how that plays out. If it doesn't end up looking the way I want to, maybe I'll just like black them out or make them a gold or something, like I have done in previous pictures in here. So I have the YR20, which is the yellowish shade. I have the YR15, which is the pumpkin yellow. And I also have the R14 light rouge, which I'm going to be using this one, the red, very, very sparingly. I'm actually going to come down here and just do, because I'm liking the almost pastel shade that is going on throughout here right now. So I don't. Necessarily. I don't want to go too crazy with the darker tones. I just want them there to add a little bit of depth. So kind of like that. I mean, those tones go decently together. It might be one of those things that I'll have to evaluate after I get a good chunk done. Because it's hard to tell right now. You always have to let it dry a little bit too, because the tone changes slightly when it dries. I don't know. Maybe I'll just do most of this corner. Kind of see how I feel. Hi, Phoebe. You can't go on the desk, sweetums. As much as you want to. Nope. Love you, cat. You are just bound and determined, aren't you? It's Definitely interesting looking. Let's come back with Oh, you're gonna make this complicated. Oh, cat, 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 I love you. Cat. Yes, you can be on my shoulder, but it. Oh, okay. Your tail's in frame. Sweetums. Just lightly touch it with the violet, but not much. Perfect. Whoops, wrong color. It's okay. And we'll get that blended out. Nope, that's gonna be wrong color. Suppose I could probably zoom into the section I'm gonna be working on. Give me just a second. There we go. See a little bit better what's going on. Okay, Kat, I don't know how much longer I can hold you. My back isn't what it used to be. Didn't add any. Highlight to that one flower. Let that one dry. Oops. There we go. This tiny little flower in here. Okay, think we're gonna start. Oops. With the leaves. How do I want to do this? Want to add? So, okay, so I'm bringing back the BG01, which is the aqua blue. I've got the BG15, which is the aqua, and then I've got the FBG2, which is the fluorescent blue green. So, it might be a little odd. Be like, April, why are you coloring this leaf blue? Well, sometimes I just feel like doing something a little bit off the wall. Let's see how this turns out. Ooh. I have to use that green as the darkest color. I like that? I mean, I kind of went all in with that very quickly, didn't I? Without really testing. I don't know how I feel. I'll be a little less aggressive with the green. Then we'll see how I feel about that. So I definitely want notes of green in there. And I wonder if we have to pull out the moon white, the beachy one. Mute that out a little bit. So it's starting here. I will to take on a bluey greeny tone, which I kind of like. Okay. So what I'm doing is I'm taking that light blue, the BG01, creating a base. And then I'm taking the fluorescent blue green, mapping out where I want the darks to be. Taking the BG15, which is the darkest of the greeny blues, adding a little bit more depth to the darks. And then I'm coming back with the BG11, which is that light green, and using that to blend out all of them. Kind of giving it almost a tropical-y feel. My concern will be when we come close to the hummingbird, whether or not all of this is too close to the tones that we did for the bird. Suppose we'll find out. mean, it's something different, I suppose. Might at some point end up grabbing another color to give it a little bit more of a tonal range. But I think I'll lay it all down first and just see how it goes. And then if I'm having issues distinguishing between my hummingbird and the rest of the picture, I'll figure that out. But I mean, it's not something I'm really going to be able to see until I get most of it laid down. And another thing is, well, maybe that will actually look well, and it's more of trying to find that hummingbird. I don't know. Because you can sort of see the more of the blue showing up down here. But, I mean, it's still awfully close. Oops. Maybe it's just the fact that I need to find a slightly lighter blue so I can go back over and maybe add back in some more blue without making it too dark. Definitely have to go through and fix up some of the lines where I'm not being very careful. A little Yeah, I think I'll just. Yeah, that'll be leaves. Could technically make it a flower, but. Too late. Snell leaves. It's my picture. There won't be any other pictures exactly like this one. That is for sure. I just want the color. Maybe. These. Oops, I'm starting with the wrong color. Getting sidetracked. Don't think it'll ultimately matter too much in the end. I think I'll get these leaves. Colored. And I'll probably call it for today because I have another live show this afternoon at 4 Central. So in about 4 hours that I also have to get ready for. So I wasn't gonna go too long today with this one, But next weekend, I might just sit down and just binge through this page. Because then it would also give me some time to sit and think on if maybe there's another color I can add to these leaves to give them a little bit more depth. I mean, they've got a little bit of range going on, but I feel like there's something that I can add that'll really make it pop a little bit more. I just, for the life of me, can't think of a way I want to take it. So I may need to think about it just a little bit. I don't know if anybody else is ever that way, but this is definitely the start of this page. Think I need to figure a few things out before I get too much further into it. But overall, I am liking how it's turning out. Maybe it's just a matter of adding maybe a cool gray of some sort to some of these inner areas. Maybe making those pop that way a little bit more. That are maybe pulling a really, really dark, rich, like a BG09. Do I want to try that right now? Oh, I need to go, but part of me is like, now that I've said it, I need to try it. Okay. So, fingers crossed that this doesn't. I might. Let's see. Do I wanna. Might pull this out a little bit. Okay. So, we got the BG09, which is the blue green. I'm gonna see. Add a little bit. Little bit more. Definitely gives it some more depth. And maybe I'll just go back in a few places. Kind of rebuild that out. happens to me every time where I'm like, I think I'm gonna leave it for here right now, and then I'm like, oh no, wait. Give me a second. Oh, and now the dogs are starting to talk. I don't know. I kind of like a little bit of that deepness. I don't think I'll add it to all of the leaves, but I think if I intersperse it here and there, it might give the leaves a little bit of a variance so that this doesn't feel as flat as it's starting to get. I don't know, what do you guys think? I don't know, I think there's something kind of nice. And maybe I'll just do it on like those big leaves where you can definitely tell the difference. But I don't necessarily want to go in and hit all of the leaves with it. Because then I think we'll probably get back into the same place that we were. But I am liking it. And everything isn't quite matchy matchy. Yeah, I think I'll hit the whole leaves here and there with this. Oops. That was very much out of the lines, but I will fix that. And I think it kind of ends up bringing back some more of those blues. So it's not quite the same as that hummingbird. And I feel like it almost plays with the orange a little better too, since it has some more blues in it. I think the blues and the orange play better together than the greens and the orange get a little bit too Halloween otherwise. Okay, yeah, I will definitely do that. But I'm actually going to just stop messing around with it too much. And then we will get back to this next Sunday. So, this is where I'm going to leave it for now. I want to thank all of you guys for hanging out with me today. I appreciate it so much. I will be back here coloring this page next Sunday at 11 Central, first weekend of May. It's hard to imagine that April's almost over. But yes, I will be back next weekend. And of course, if you want to come and see my second live show today, I will be talking with Shay from over at Shay Geeks Out about the book Cress by Marissa Meyer. I love the Lunar Chronicle series. So if you want to come and hang out with us then, that's at 4 Central. But otherwise, I will see all of you guys next Sunday. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, and I heart your beautiful faces. Bye.